U.S. health officials are considering extending the eligibility for a second COVID booster dose to people under 50. The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention said they are in talks with the Food and Drug Administration regarding the possible expansion of the booster drive. That's as the number of cases nationwide over the past month increased threefold. The CDC said the average number of daily cases rose by 26% to about 94,000 cases per day. The seven-day average for hospitalizations also increased to 3,000 per day. The U.S. reports its first case of the monkeypox virus after a string of new cases popped up in Europe. The Massachusetts Department of Public Health confirmed Wednesday a man who recently traveled to Canada was infected with a virus. It said the patient has been hospitalized and is in good condition and does not pose a risk to the public. Authorities are looking into whether this is connected to small outbreaks in Europe. Spain and Portugal have detected around 30 suspected cases of monkeypox, while confirmed cases in the UK have climbed to 9. The World Health Organization said it was coordinating with the UK to investigate the outbreak.
Well, what we're looking at here is a number of studies that are ongoing to better understand, number one, the extent of circulation of monkeypox in London among communities with men of sex with men, and making sure that testing is occurring, that isolation of men or people who are suspected of having monkeypox are isolated and that they receive the appropriate clinical care.
A health expert expects COVID-19 cases to rise in the Philippines after the detection of a more infectious Omicron subvariant. Dr. Ronjin Solante says the expected uptick may be seen in areas with low vaccination rates, but he believes it will not overwhelm the country's hospitals.
Vulnerable ang population natin, especially for those na wala talagang bakuna, kung doon sa may mga bakuna, especially for those getting the booster. So there's a possibility, no? Malaking posibilidad yan na medyo tataas ang mga kaso. But I don't think it will be enough to affect our hospitalization rate.
In other news, U.S. investigators believe the crashing of the China Eastern flight last March 21st, killing all its 132 passengers and crew, was deliberately done by someone on board. The flight data recorders had been sent to the U.S. for analysis. Citing people familiar with the probe, the Wall Street Journal reports the data showed someone input orders on the controls to send the Boeing jet into a nosedive. U.S. officials believe their conclusion is backed up by the fact that Chinese investigators have so far not indicated any problems with the aircraft or flight controls. U.S. and Boeing officials, however, have declined to comment on the report. The plane was traveling from Kunming in Guangzhou when it inexplicably plunged into a mountainside in what is China's deadliest crash, or in what has become to know or what is China's deadliest crash in around 30 years.